I started the project 2 years ago, really through my own personal experience. I have a daughter, Emily, who's 9, with severe learning disabilities. And I looked around for support, daytime respite care specifically for her. I was quite shocked to discover that there isn't actually a lot out there, really, that really met my needs and hers. So she doesn't sleep at night, which actually was quite good for me, because it meant I had to do a lot of research and look into and plan out how I would start a project, what model I would use. Social enterprise for me seemed to fit quite nicely in that it was, I don't know, I mean, as Melanie just said, you have to have a commercial aspect, there has to be a need that people have to want to use the service. But equally, it wasn't driven by the need to make those money. And that, for me, really sat quite well, because that wasn't ever my intention in the first place. It wasn't to become an outreach grant or whatever. It was to set up a service that I thought people might need. So we started in July 2010, supporting 3 families for long summer holidays, and then we are now supporting 60 families in 2 years, and our families travel to us. We're based in Worcester, they come from Hales Owen, they come from Evesham, Stratford, Ulster, Bromsgrove, all over the region, really, and I think that's indicative probably of the lack of services that we're experiencing here in Worcestershire. We're offering daytime respite care to families with children who've got disabilities. We're helping children learn new skills through leisure, because we're open every school holiday and every Saturday, and we are the only projects in Worcestershire to open for those times. Other projects will only open for 7 Saturdays a year. They will only open for 4 weeks in the summer. They're not open every half term. But I suppose for me, being mum, and knowing what the need is, to me, I think, well, we will have this project open. We will have it open every holiday, and we will have it open for longer hours, so it really does drive and meet the needs of the people that are using it. We have a blast, actually, our children. They go all over the place. They go to snowdown, they go swimming, they go horse riding. So it's also about giving children the opportunity to try new experiences, things that parents can't or don't want to try because they're scared. Things that children already enjoy that we want to nurture. Or completely new things like grass mountain boarding, which they absolutely love. So it's about giving kids new experiences. I mean, I'm very passionate about letting children who've got disabilities try new things, because I think so often they get wrapped up in cotton wool because we have this perception that they can't achieve. And, you know, it does take a bit of courage to let a 9-year-old go down a steep bank on a board. But if they've had a blast at the end of it, that's all you can get. So it's sort of, I've already covered that. We started in 2010. She's now 9, nearly 10. That's what spurred me on, was that I couldn't find any care that truly met my needs. We did surveys of other parents and carers to see if I was right. Basically, I was thinking I couldn't be the only person who thought this. So you need to establish your needs. You can do that by questionnaires, which is what we did. And I think, going back to what Melanie said and Dan said, social enterprise works at its best when it brings in other people to support it. In fact, I would go as far as to say we wouldn't have our project now if it hadn't been for Worcester Community Housing taking a leap of faith, probably in me personally, I think, initially. And they've given us a building rent free, as it's turned out, 3 years. And they're only now taking their rent because we've actually got a lotto grant for 5 years. So that covers the rent. And even then, they're not taking all of it, they're taking half of it. And New Hope was named because I wanted to think of something that would offer hope, New Hope, to families like mine going forward into the future. And that's where the name comes from. That just tells you our growth. difficulties started, and where we're at, where we're at now, and that's actually 62 now, so we've got 2 mature pieces. These are some of our children. They do gardening projects. This is outside of our project, so they're planting tomatoes up there. Quotes from children, which I think is quite nice. That's my daughter Emily on the end of the buggy. And you can see the age difference here with our children as well. A lot of projects separate our ages. They have up to 11 and then 11 up to 16. I actually don't agree with that, because I think what happens is, A, they don't get to meet friends. You miss out on the older lad here, taking care of the smaller one here in his own way, supporting him, either to do new things, or, and the younger children look up to the older ones, so it gives the older ones a sense of responsibility and a way forward. That was taken to a farm park out the top of being important construction. Strawberry picking, which we actually made smoothies with when we got back. That's the mountain walking. This mum particularly really struggles with her son. He's quite challenging. He's now 9. He has autism. She has a little one as well who's only 18 months old, so for her it's juggling bringing up 2 children, one with severe disability, one without. And her, what she says to me is that it's helpful being able to send her child to us so that she can spend time with the other child, which I think often you forget in this. We're so focused on the child with disability, if we're not careful, we forget about siblings. Run by Triodos Bank, that we didn't win overall, but we did win the public vote on. And I think if you look at what Triodos do, you get linked into other social enterprises where you can find out what people are doing. And I have to say, listening to your talk this morning about other social enterprises in the region, I actually find it quite interesting to hear about what other people are doing. And that there are people out there like us who aren't doing this for the sole purpose of making money. Yes, we have to meet our costs. Yes, we have to generate some profit if we can. But that isn't our sole motivator for doing what we do. Most of us, I think, are doing it because we want to make a difference, we want to see the services improve. I take the view personally that for me, I had a choice. I could either put up and shut up with what was on offer, which wasn't a great deal, or I could do something about it. So with a lot of help from a lot of people, it isn't just me, I have a brilliant staff team, you can make a difference. You just need to have some dedication and a bit of hard work.